Hello everyone, welcome back to our new video. In this video, I will give you more information about the top 5 best waterproof cameras that are available on the market. Actually, I try to make popularity, quality, price, durability, user opinion and more. If you need more information about this products, please check the link in a description section below. Don't forget subscribe this channel for view future of videos. Let's start this video. Starting at number 5, we have Olympus TUF TG6. The Olympus TUF TG6 is an ultra-rugged camera with a 1.2 MP, 1.5.3 BSI CMOS sensor, 25-100mm equivalent lens, sensor shift image stabilization, and a host of environmental sensors for tracking things like location and temperature. The camera is waterproof to 15 meters 50 feet, shockproof from 2.1 meters 7 feet, as well as freeze-proof, crush-proof, and dust-proof. The pocketable TG6 fits well in the hand, though buttons are small and easy to press accidentally, and the control dial is hard to turn. The camera's metal body is solid, and the dual locks on its two doors give added confidence that water will stay on the outside. The LCD is bright and easy to see outdoors, but it scratches very easily, making a screen protector a wise purchase. Olympus offers many accessories for the TG6, including conversion lenses and macro lights. TG6's contrast detect AF system is responsive and accurate. A subject tracking feature is offered, but it doesn't do a great job of sticking to its target. One of the TG6's strengths is macro shooting, with a 1 cm 0.4 minimum distance that works above and below the water. You can shoot bursts at up 20 FPS, and the TG6's battery life of 340 shots per charge is above average. Image quality is pretty standard for a camera with a small, 1.5.3 sensor. Colors are pleasant and photos are sharp, though noise reduction is on the strong side, reducing detail. The TG6 can shoot raw images, so you can adjust noise reduction, among other things, to your liking. Don't expect miracles at high ISOs, as the TG6's sensor is about the same as a smartphone's. They expect video quality to be the same as on the TG5, which is to say, good. 4K 30p video can be captured, and 1080 at up to 60 FPS, both at a bitrate of 102 megabits per second. A high-speed mode can shoot full HD at 120 FPS, and even faster at lower resolutions. Video controls are minimal and, as you'd expect, there are no mic or headphone sockets. As with its predecessors, Olympus's TUF TG6 is one of the best waterproof cameras on the market. The overall package of better-than-average image quality, a broad feature set, and great build quality make buying one a no-brainer. Moving on at number 4, we have SeaLife DC2000. The SeaLife DC2000 is the only waterproof compact camera on the market to use a 1.0 sensor. In addition, it has a fast 31mm equiv. f1.8 lens, which will bring in more light than the lenses on other compact waterproof cameras. The DC2000 can operate down to 18 meters 60 feet, but with the included housing increasing that increases to an impressive 60 meters 200 feet. The bare camera is also shockproof to 1.5 meters 5 feet, freeze-proof down to minus 18 degrees Celsius 0 degrees Fahrenheit on land, and 0.5 degrees Celsius 33 degrees Fahrenheit underwater. On its own, the DC2000 is about the same size and weight as other compact waterproof cameras. The controls are a little unusual compared to competitive models though, and take a while to get used to. The camera offers numerous scene modes, several for underwater shooting, as well as manual exposure controls with RAW support. Wireless connectivity purports to support remote shooting and GPS tagging among other features. The dedicated waterproof housing adds considerable bulk and triples the weight of the bare camera, but of course, that's not an issue underwater. The DC2000 has a contrast detect autofocus system that's speedy and accurate in good light, slowing down as light levels drop in beneath the water. At the normal focus setting, the minimum subject distance is 15 centimeters 6 inches, and with macro enabled this reduces to 9 centimeters 3.5 inches. The camera has several continuous shooting modes, with the strangely named endless burst mode limited to 10 photos at 10 FPS. Raw burst shooting isn't supported, and the camera is unusable for the roughly 5 seconds it takes to write a RAW file to the card. Battery life is roughly 200 shots per charge, which is poor for this class of camera, but not terrible considering the comparatively large sensor. Image quality on the DC2000 is a notable step up from other waterproof compacts, due to the combination of a large 1-inch sensor and high-quality lens. Color in JPEGs is generally pleasing, though noise reduction is a little clumsy, which is particularly noticeable at higher ISO values. The larger sensor and RAW capture give greater editing latitude and access to greater dynamic range than its smaller sensor competitors. Low light image quality is also very good, but autofocus is prone to hunting in dim conditions. The DC2000 can record 1080p and 30p videos for up to 30 minutes, and the quality is good. The stabilization looks to be a combination of digital and optical and works fairly well. Autofocus, on the other hand, is prone to hunting. It's best to lock down your focus and disable the continuous AF setting in the menu. You also don't get any control over exposure parameters, though the metering for auto exposure is solid and exposure transitions are smooth. For those who aren't hardcore divers but are in the market for a waterproof compact, the DC2000 is the oddball choice that also happens to deliver the best image quality in the segment. If you can get around the controls and slow RAW capture, you'll find the DC2000 to be a capable photographic companion, but if you don't need superior image quality, its operational quirks may be a turnoff to some users. At number 3, we have Nikon Coolpix W300. The Coolpix W300 is Nikon's premium rugged camera, built around a 16MP BSI CMOS sensor and a versatile 24-120mm equivalent f2.8-4.9 zoom lens. It offers features not found on budget models, like a GPS, compass, and altimeter, as well as 4K video capture. The W300 has a solid build quality and a bright, high-resolution LCD. The camera's card and battery live behind a single lockable door, minimizing the number of seals you need to keep clean. It's waterproof to 30 meters 100 feet, shockproof from 2.4 meters 7.9 feet and freeze-proof to minus 10 degrees Celsius 14 degrees Fahrenheit. The W300 has a movement-based way of controlling some functions while wearing diving gloves, but they didn't always get consistent behavior from it. The camera contains a database of points of interest that can be attached to photos you've taken. The SnapBridge Wi-Fi Plus Bluetooth system makes it easy to send images to your phone. The W300's contrast detect autofocus system offers relatively good performance. There is a subject tracking mode, but once you press the shutter release tracking stops. At full resolution, the W300 can shoot 5 shots at 7 FPS. Battery life is also rated to a credible 280 shots per charge, which means you shouldn't need to worry about it dying on you too soon. Image quality from the W300 is typical of the smaller sensor cameras in this class, with fine detail smudged away by noise reduction. The W300's lens seems a bit soft, as well. Colors are pleasant, though, and exposures are accurate. The lack of RAW capture limits your ability to edit your images taken in challenging conditions, such as underwater, but that's a rare feature in this class. The W300 can shoot UHD 4K video at up to 30p for high detail capture and it looks very good, with effective shake reduction. If you want 120fps shooting, you'll have to capture it at VGA resolution. Aside from a wind filter, there aren't any real controls for capturing video. The Nikon Coolpix W300 impresses with its rugged credentials and feature set. Image quality is par for the course, meaning that it's more than acceptable for web use and sharing, and the colors are nice and vivid, but things get soft and smudgy on close inspection. The W300 isn't the best waterproof camera in its class, but it's up there. At number 2, we have Panasonic Lumix DCTS7, FT7. The Panasonic Lumix DCTS7 is the first rugged compact camera to have an electronic viewfinder. This boldly styled camera also has a 20MP BSI CMOS sensor, 28-128mm equiv. f3.3-5.9 lens and 4K video capture. While it lacks a GPS receiver, location data can be added later via a smartphone, the TS7 does have a compass and altimeter. The Panasonic DCTS7 is a large, somewhat heavy camera. It feels a bit plasticky but it's as waterproof to 31 meters 102 feet, shockproof from 2 meters 6.6 feet, crushproof to 100 kg force 220 lbf and freezeproof to minus 10 degrees Celsius plus 14 degrees Fahrenheit. It has a giant shutter release, good for those wearing gloves, though other buttons are small and mushy. The TS7's electronic viewfinder is small and has no eye sensor, so you must press a button to switch between it and the LCD. Some users might be bothered by color tearing caused by the field sequential panel used in the finder. That said, an EVF is very helpful when shooting outdoors. The TS7 has a manual exposure mode, but only two aperture choices are available at any given time. The DCTS7 has a 49-point contrast detect autofocus system which focuses quickly in most cases. Panasonic claims that the TS7 can also track a moving subject at 7 FPS. The camera can shoot at 12 FPS with focus and exposure locked. The minimum focus distance in macro mode is 3 cm 1.2 inches. Battery life is rated at 350 shots per charge, which is excellent for this class. Their initial impressions are that image quality from the DCTS7 is a bit better than average for this class. Photos look very good at the kind of resolutions used for social sharing, though upon closer inspection you'll see that fine detail has been smudged by noise reduction and a relatively soft lens. The camera doesn't support raw capture, so things like color, white balance, and noise reduction cannot be edited after the fact. The TS7 can capture 4K UHD video at 30p or 24p with a 100 megabits per second bitrate, and quality is best in class. The only caveat is that you may notice that straight edges appear to lean when the camera is quickly panned. A 1080/60p option is also available, as is a 720/120p high-speed mode. With no dedicated movie mode, the only manual video control is a wind cut filter. Panasonic has a number of features that take advantage of its 4K capabilities, including 8MP frame grabs, called 4K Photo by Panasonic, and post focus. The TS7 appears to offer a good mix of features and impressive rugged credentials. It doesn't have RAW and the electric viewfinder isn't great, but it's better than not having one at all. While not best in class, the TS7 is definitely worth considering. And finally, at number 1. Ricoh WG60. The WG60 is Ricoh's entry-level rugged camera. It features a 16MP, 1.5.3, sensor and an unstabilized 28-140mm equivalent lens. The camera is waterproof to 14 meters 46 feet, shockproof from heights of 1.6 meters 5.3 feet, and freezeproof to minus 10 degrees Celsius plus 14 degrees Fahrenheit. Despite being introduced in late 2018, the WG60 lacks Wi-Fi. The WG60 is an unusually shaped camera made largely of composite materials. It's easy to hold, though the grip is a bit slippery and the controls cluttered. It has many scene modes but little in the way of manual control. The rear screen is low resolution and its wide aspect ratio leaves a lot of unused space when shooting stills. It offers a single customizable button that opens a shortcut menu, and the design of the main menu is very dated. The WG60's autofocus performance is average in good light and sluggish in low light. The camera has a subject tracking mode, but it doesn't stick to its subjects very well. The WG60 can take 300 shots per charge, average for this class, and can be charged over USB. The WG60's image quality isn't great, but it's fine for sharing on social media. Colors are pleasant, though noise reduction is strong, smudging away fine detail. Not surprisingly, this inexpensive camera does not support RAW shooting. The WG60 can capture full HD video at up to 30 FPS. From what they have seen thus far, the video quality is decent, but a bit soft. If you want a high-speed 120fps mode, you'll need to drop down to 1280x720. There aren't any video capture aids on the camera, and it's worth noting that it only records mono sound. The Ricoh WG60 is one of many low-cost rugged cameras, with specs and performance that mirror those of its peers. Image and video quality will be just like your smartphone, except your smartphone can't function 14 meters underwater. Something that makes the WG60 a less than ideal choice is the lack of image stabilization and Wi-Fi, which can be found on most other cameras in its price range. Thank you for watching, guys. I hope like you this videos. If this video helpful to you, please make comments and subscribe. If you have any question related this product, you can leave a comment down below. I hope back to you as soon as possible.